Good morning, Pirates. Today is Friday, November 10th, 2023. I'm Bella.
I'm Zayden.
And I'm Mariana.
And this is your Pirate TV.
Karen Martinez Vega.
Trace Coley.
Casey White.
Landon Ogre.
Karen Martinez Vega here, and these are the things you need to know. Today, the NGR OTC Color Guard will be at Neil Armstrong Elementary at 8 a.m. There will be a girls' soccer match at Cape Coral at 6:30 p.m. Boys' soccer will play versus Fort Myers at home at 6:30 p.m. And finally, tomorrow, the band and NGR OTC will be taking part in the Veterans Day Parade at 7:30 a.m. I'm Karen Martinez Vega with Pirate TV.
Hey Pirates, I'm Mariana.
And I'm Zayden.
And this is your word of the day. The word of the day is paradox, which is a noun. It means seemingly absurd or self-contradictory statement or proposition that, when investigated or explained, may prove to be well-founded or true.
Here's paradox in a sentence. In a strange paradox, the medicine made Harry sick before it cured him. And that's it for your word of the day.
Hi, Pirates. I'm Karen Martinez Vega, here for a reminder for our student drivers. In order to park on campus, a parking pass is required. If you would like to purchase a parking pass, you can do so at the student office. The cost is $45, and you will need your driver's license as well as a copy of your insurance when completing an application. Any students that do not have a parking pass paid for will have their vehicle stickered with a notification about expectations for parking on campus. Please make sure that your parking sticker is visible in the front window of your vehicle to avoid a violation sticker. Any students who fail to abide by the rules will be subject to school discipline. I'm Karen Martinez Vega with Pirate TV.
Hey Pirates, do you have a crazy talent that you would be excited to show off? Like singing, dancing, or even doing gymnastics? Well, you're in luck because our school has a talent show on December 14th. It would be located in the auditorium at 6:30 p.m. Auditions will take place during 7th period and after school in F3 on November 13th through the 17th. We hope to see you there.
Hello Pirates, I'm Karen Martinez Vega here from another edition of This Day in History. Since tomorrow is Veterans Day, here's some relevant history. On November 10, 1775, the United States Marine Corps was created by the Second Continental Congress, with the first Marines enlisting under Commandant Samuel Nicholas. Although the Marine Corps is an independent branch, they work closely with the U.S. Navy. The military branch was originally formed to help provide defense in the Revolutionary War. Marines are known for carrying out operations on land, sea, and in the air. The Marine Corps continues to play an important role in our country's defense to this day. To commemorate the formation of the military branch, Marines host a traditional ball as well as a cake-cutting ceremony to celebrate. Happy Veterans Day to all veterans who have served in all of the military branches. Your service to the nation is greatly appreciated. I'm Karen Martinez Vega with Pirate TV.
Hi Pirates, I'm Bella, and welcome to another edition of The Box Office. at Freddy's, the iconic indie horror game that has captivated gamers for years, has finally made its way to the big screen, and what a remarkable journey it has been. The film adaptation is nothing short of a cinematic masterpiece, blending heart-pounding suspense, impeccable storytelling, and a genuine love for the source material. Director Emma Tammy has delivered a brilliant homage to the franchise that will thrill fans and newcomers alike.
Hey Pirates, I'm Evan Dunbar. I'm here today with Casey White. We're doing something new today, world news, but I wrote everything for Casey. Casey wrote everything for me. We have no idea what we wrote. Casey, go ahead.
I'm absolutely terrified. Walmart has pledged to spend $1 million to charity. Man, I love Walmart. I've been shoplifting there for years.
It's an awful person. Deer charges through Wisconsin crowded restaurant after asking his date, what's venison?
What is venison?
Deer meat. It's deer meat, Casey.
The NYPD has announced there will be heightened security at the next marathon. Hopefully this means there will be less security for Walmart, making it easier for me to shoplift.
Wow, you're just a criminal.
I'm a terrible person.
You're an awful, awful person. In European news, couple stuck on the Eiffel Tower decides to get married. In other news, couple stuck in marriage divorces and visits Eiffel Tower in celebration.
A Southern California wildfire has prompted widespread evacuation. Hopefully this means the Walmarts are empty and an easy target for me to shoplift from.
Wow, you really just got one thing on your mind.
Just one thing.
Just
Walmart.
Just shoplifting. Ride passengers are rescued after dangling upside down for an hour and a half, and you thought your Uber was bad.
I didn't ride that one. China and the U.S. have agreed to compromise on nuclear arms control. But the only arms they have to worry about is controlling is these. Watch out.
Have you been hitting the gym?
Actually, yeah, as of recently. Thank you.
You're looking bigger, Casey.
Thanks, Evan Dunbar. Boosting my ego a little bit.
A rare spotless giraffe born in a zoo. Happy birthday, Windex. What does that even mean?
His name is Windex, like the brand Windex, it clears spots off of...
Oh, okay. I get it. That's creative.
It was very creative. Thank you. Daylight saving times just happened last weekend. Daylight is going to need saving from me.
Wow. Massive.
Thank you.
In other news, the largest search for the Loch Ness Monster opened since 50 years. Turns out it was just Mr. Baker going for a swim.
50 years old, Mr. Baker's absolutely ancient.
You can take the credit away from Casey, he wrote that one.
Starbucks is increasing their barista wage by 3%. In spite of this, they still can't seem to spell Casey, the face of Pirate TV White, correctly on my coffee. Come on, Starbucks.
Despicable. They gotta do better.
Shut them down.
They got to do better. A massive dump of pasta in New Jersey sets on fire. Little Italy declares a day of national mourning.
Good. Two Georgia children have found a massive lizard under a porch in their neighborhood. In related news, I will be releasing two more.
Well, that's awful. Looks like that's it for our jokes today. Thank you for watching. I'm Evan Dunbar here with Casey White.
Have an amazing day.
Hey, Pirates. I'm Evan Dunbar here with today's Big Brain Trivia Challenge.
I'm not a smart man. She's a liar.
Welcome to the Big Brain Challenge. Information guaranteed to blow your mind.
Smartest man alive!
Today's trivia question comes from college football. In 1869, Rutgers would beat Princeton 6-4 and was regarded as the first ever win in college football. For this, they were rewarded an imaginary award called the MacGuffin. As the story goes, any team to beat the MacGuffin holder would claim it themselves until ultimately they would lose and the MacGuffin would switch hands. Today's question is, which university currently holds the MacGuffin? Would it be A, Ohio State, B, Oregon State, C, Washington, or D, Florida Atlantic? you guessed C, you'd be correct. The Washington Huskies won the MacGuffin last year in a game against Oregon. They have been undefeated since then and held the MacGuffin for almost a full year. My name is Evan Dunbar, and that was your Big Brain Trivia Challenge. What's going on, Pirates? I'm Evan Dunbar here today with the weather. We're looking at a wind chill map today because it's pretty windy this time of year, but clearly not in the south. There's no wind chill because it never gets cold. New England, obviously going to be cold. Canada, cold, obviously. That's kind of what they're known for. Frontier states cold, obviously. California, going to be about 40 today with...
California suck!
Who likes California anyways?
I love California.
Shut up. But let's look at the Port Charlotte weather. Mid-80s all week, a lot of cloud cover. Gonna get rainy near the end of the week, which is new. Last month has been pretty dry for average. Windy as well, obviously fairly windy. That's pretty much it. Cloud cover, wind, rain. Gonna be a pretty boring week, but I was Evan Dunbar and I'll see you next week.
That's it for today's broadcast. See you next time for some more Pirate TV.
The best news on the seven seas!
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 The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down at the big lake they call Gitche-Gumee. The lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. That good ship and true was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. Ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland.